Good morning, afternoon, and hello. How's everybody today? Guess who had technical issues again? Yeah, so I don't know. I think whatever. Hey, thanks for joining in. I hope this finds you well, and I hope that widescreen. I wasn't widescreen yesterday. I was a bit worried about that. So today, Wednesday, middle of the week. There's a lot going on in everyone's lives, which is great. I spent the morning giving thanks to a lot of people for their birthday wishes, and I was humbled and joyful doing that. It was a great experience, and thank you for giving me that experience today, and last night as well, and yesterday. And so that's that. Was it another year over, another one about to begin, la la la, and stuff like that. And very proud to be here. As to either quote Keith Richards or to paraphrase him, at least it's great to be here. It's great to be anywhere. Really is. And for right now here with you today, it's great to be here with you today, because it means a lot to me that you take your time to join in. And I endeavor to do more with this over time. Certainly I've had the practice anyway, and there is a format to this. We all know that now at this stage, and I think I enjoy doing it. And let's all strive towards the medicine show, road show. And it could be a video radio show type of thing. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. But certainly I like doing it. And there you go. So thanks again for joining in. Love your work. I love me. I love you. We're all here today. So we're going to light a candle. And today's candle is for all of those who are with us today in spirit and energy, and all those people in our hearts that we think of every day. And there's a situation I read, again, I won't be able to quote it properly, but there's a shout out to all those people, our friends, who we're not in contact with them every day. We're not, we might see them. Like a friend of mine, right? I haven't seen him in nearly a year, right? And like we're on the phone, we're in contact with each other, but like he's my oldest friend, and outside my family, of course. And we were on the phone yesterday, chatting away, la la la, all that stuff. But I don't think I've seen him since summer last year. And it's a thing, whatever, fair enough. But it's not like we're both busy, we're both doing our things, that's okay, whatever. But we used to see each other very regularly, and I mean, we will continue to see each other, all that stuff when things settle down, this thing gets out of the way for a start. But I'm sure you have people that you might have seen for a very, very long time, but they're still here. They're still in your heart. That's the important part. Okay, they're still here. They're still your mates. They're still your buddies. They're still on the phone. You might chat to them on the thing here, tap it away or whatever, and that's all good. But never lose sight of that, right? How important your friends are to you. But also now for the crack, listen, how important you are to your friends, because you are important to your friends. I certainly know my friends are important to me. As I say, I am a reflection of the company I keep. So, may I be so bold as to say I keep jolly, jolly good company. There you go. Thank you very much. So this is for them. This is for you. This is for me. This is for all of us to light our way through today, and for the future, and to give thanks for our friends, our buddies, our mates. And our friends, they keep us grounded. They really do. Like, we can lose. I know personal experience. I've lost myself. I've disappeared right up my fundamental, a couple of times at least over time. And the I've had the graceful experience of my friends gently and perhaps sometimes not so gently bringing me back down to earth, and that's great. And I've done it as well for people too, not two people, four people, and so it's a circular thing. It goes around stuff like that. But I have to say, I'm grateful that I didn't. When I did lose myself, that's fair enough. But I was brought back. And sometimes I brought myself back, in fairness, all that stuff. But this is the thing. Your friends are you outside of you. Okay? And they help you keep you where you should be, where you need to be, perhaps, and where you want to be. But they keep you grounded. And it's not necessarily their job. But it's one of the attributes, one of the assets that they bring into your life to keep you together, to mind you. And obviously you will reciprocate, you will mind them, because that's, it's a two-way street. And so to my friends, thanks for being my buddies. Thanks for being who you are to help me be who I am. And this is for you, this is for my mates, and all the use, whatever. But this is for the lads who have journeyed with me to this very day. So thank you for that, and I love you. So now get a little bit emotional, and that's okay too. Wednesday, good day for emotions. Any day with a Y in it is a good day for emotions. Might be the title of my new poem. Anyway, so here's the sage for us. This is for you. This is for me. And I want to say thank you for joining in, because you're taking your time to be here, and I appreciate that. This is for you, little cleanse. And this is for me. This is for our ancestors, for those of us, those of around us who have gone on to the next realm. And this is for the spirits and all those around us as well. I'll put it out. I'm going to disappear into smoke. So now, there you are. So we're going to do some Reiki, and with the Reiki, we are going to Morning, Caroline. How are you? Hey, Frankie. How are you? What's the crack? You well? Good stuff. Thanks for joining in. So we're going to do some Reiki, but before we do the Reiki, we're going to do some smiling, and the smiling will involve the actual physical action of smiling, and that will release your serotonin, which is your happy molecule, hormone, whatever. And so if you would care to join me for a 15 second, 16 second smiling session, go on, or even a 17 second smiling session to bring in a bit of rock and roll and a television program. 17 seconds, a song by The Cure, 17, or Danger UXB, which was an old television program about mines, landmines in the First World War, and you had 17 seconds to disarm them. So that's probably where The Cure got the 17 seconds title from, or not. Don't know. Either way. So we go for 16 seconds for the crack, because we can. There you go. Anyway, join me, please, now. Thank you. One, two, three. Now, these are all smiley. Good stuff. Bring it on. So we're going to do some Reiki, and this Reiki energy is for us, for you and me. And I will ask you that you say the words, "I am open and ready to receive." And those words will allow the energy to go to you. And I will call upon your higher selves, who are your future selves. And with that, then we will all join together. And I'll also ask you, if you want, if you care, to imagine that we're all sitting in a field, in a circle, in a stadium, wherever it is you want to be. We're all holding hands. Okay, so there you go. So I'll see you in a few minutes. Thank you. Thank you. Now, just bring our hands together and let the energy grow into a bright white light. We bring that light into our hearts. Now let the energy go where it needs to go. And we stretch.
How are you all?
Yeah. And then we wiggle our fingers and wiggle our toes, and we let the energy go to where it knows. Ha ha, little rhyme.
So now we're going to do some drumming, but first of all, I'm going to read some cards, a card,
and see what the message is today from the medicine woman in our guidebook. And I do hope, first of all, you know that I'm not promoting this, so not in any way endorsing it. I'm just telling you that I'm using it. This is what I use. I have a few other decks as well, but this one is something just resonates wholly with me.
Oh, hang on, here's one stood out already.
The Five of Stones. Well, listen, this is sitting there appearing without having been pulled. Let's see if I can pull the other one just for the crack. See. What harvest now, madam matron? I think yes. I'm gonna read two of those two. Yeah. So the first of the five stones. Four stones. Five of stones. Giveaway. Prayer. I shall love my work enough that it is fulfilling in itself. Though I have paid a price and can rightly ask others to pay a price for what I offer, I will give away some of my work simply because I've loved it, and for love it can be given. I abide by the spiritual law of tithing. 10% of my bounty belongs to my people. I give not in order to receive, but because I have already received. Mother Earth blesses me every day with the elements of true happiness. Earth, wind, sky, trees, flowers, the song of birds, and the foods that nourish me are but a few of her gifts. In her name, I return my wares to others. Lesson. It may seem as though you have lost something. Your situation has changed and some of your assets are gone. But remember, you took this risk when you were at the Four of Stones. Basic survival. Did you dip into your security stash and sacrifice your well-being and sacrifice your own well-being to serve someone else's will? Did you hold back your talents, abilities, or true convictions from the material with which you were working? Don't get attached to this temporary poverty role by adopting a poor me attitude. Reevaluate your position. Take stock of your current resources and review the lessons of the stones up through this card. It is time to exert mental discipline. Appreciate yourself. Practice contentment with what is. Reimagine your future and relax into the wealth you already have. Change is near. The giveaway can be a totally positive experience if you have provided for your own well-being. Put your heart and soul into your work for the sake of itself rather than for a reward, and are willing to give your first efforts away to someone you love. This is the spiritual level this card is asking you to reach. Now, that certainly resonates with me, and I'm sure it would resonate with you in such a way that we all have stuff to share with others, and it is a good thing to do so, because sharing is caring, as we know. And also it gives others, it gives you an experience for start, but also the shared experience literally with someone else and what you're doing with them, for them, and together. So yeah, and the harvest, I have to reach this, because that's a Wheel of Fortune harvest. Now there's something, yeah, it's a big, long, large one. So harvest, number and meaning, 10. Manifestation, traditional name, Wheel of Fortune, medicine, woman, energy, the season's harvest. I thank you very much for that. Affirmation, all that I have allowed to dwell in my imagination has become true through my words and actions. The creator is embodied in me. I gratefully accept the harvest of my creation. The card speaks. You have heard it spoken. The word has become flesh and dwells among us. You began the Wheel of Fortune spinning when you took a gamble. As the fool, you stepped into new territory. You tried using your present personality and environment in some way, new ways, as the magician. As the High Priestess, you began to see yourself as a casual, causal force. Then, as Empress, you looked with love upon the person full of potential that you are. As Emperor, you began to make a structure to put that potential to work. Listening to the voice within, the Hierophant, you figured out just how to interface with the world. Working together, you became lovers with your inner world, bringing it into outer manifestation. In the Chariot, you experienced your accomplishment. Then you build up your inner strength until you had stand. You could stand alone and steady as the Hermit, lighting the way for others to follow. This is the turning of the wheel of tarot. I bring you the results of this whole energy cycle. Your task now is to accept, rejoice, be glad in what is, and go on. Just as the gambler might have a drink to the game after a round of cards, whether she or he won or lost, celebrate now just because you have come this far. Give a toast to the flow. Shake hands with your friends for a game well played. As a medicine woman, you understand now that the seeds you gave to the wind through your nurturing have grown into the food that nourishes yourself. You have used the tools at hand, seeking vision from within as to how to take these everyday things and make them work for you. Yes, indeed, I am very happy with that. Okay, meditation. Imagine that you are sitting before a large wheel of fortune. Give it a spin and see if the jackpot is yours today. If you are off the mark, ask what is interfering with your good luck. I have that sorted anyway, so that's good. Yeah, I am chuffed with that. I'm taking that hugely personally. I think you should too. Anyway, right. Drumming. Got this in drumming for about 10 minutes. And if you care to join me with that, I'm going to heat up my drum. Hey, Orla, how are you? Thanks for joining in. So the drumming and yeah, I'm going to use the rattle. The rattle will connect us to the heavens. The drumming will connect us to the earth. And we will be in between like a child of the mother of the earth that we are. So that's the important part. But remember, have a little word with your inner child. See how he or she is today. And give him a little hug while we're on this little journey. I'll see you in a few minutes, all right? And thanks for joining in. Really appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, there is there. I don't know about you, but I went off on one there, and that was nice. Hope you enjoyed that one. So again, thanks for joining in. How are you, Susan? Thank you for joining in. So now we're going to do some Reiki in a minute, and this Reiki will go for the will be sent out to all the frontline workers, the emergency workers, and anyone and everyone who is currently helping keeping things flowing. And a lot of people are back to work next week, and in this country anyway. And so I hope that goes well for y'all, including me. And so yeah, but I will read a little poem because I can. Right, this is Canto 2 of, I think, no, I'm not going to do that. Nope. What is going on here? Oh, John Milton. Paradise Lost. Okay, John Milton. How soon hath time? How soon hath time, the subtle thief of youth, stolen on his wing my 23rd year? My hasting days fly on with full career, but my late spring no bud or blossom shooth. Perhaps my semblance might deceive the truth that I to manhood am arrived so near, and inward ripens doth much less appear, and inward ripens doth much less appear, but some more timely happy spirits endeth. Yet be it less or more, or soon or slow, it shall be still in strictest measure even. To that same lot, how mean or high, towards which time leads me, on the will of heaven. All is, if I have grace to use it so, as ever, in my great task master's eye. When I consider, by John Milton. When I consider how my light is spent ere half my days in this dark world and wide, and that one talent which is death to hide, lodged with me useless, though my soul more bent to serve therewith my maker and present my true account, least he returning chide, doth God exact day labor, light denied. I fondly ask, but patience to prevent that murmur soon replies, God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. Who best bear his mild yoke, they serve him best, his state is kingly. Thousands at his bidding speed and post o'er land and ocean without rest, they also serve who only stand and wait. Now they are. Right, we're going to some Reiki. This Reiki is for, like I said, the frontline workers, and for you, and for me, and for our higher selves, and for our inner child, and for anyone you would care to send this out to. But definitely, defiantly, this is for the frontline workers, the nurses, the doctors, the hospital staff, who include the caterers, the catering staff, the cleaners, the porters, the security. And then we have the Gardaí, the military, the army, the navy, the air corps. We have the truck drivers, the shop workers, the suppliers, the farmers, the and people like that, and everyone who is helping keep going, the binnies, the bin collectors, and sanitation maintenance workers. There you go. How's that? Street sanitation. But whatever. Either way, that's for them and us. And we send it out to them. So here we go. So I ask you to join with me, please, for the next few minutes. And I ask you to say these words. I'm open and ready to receive. And those words will allow the energy to go to you, through you, and to them. All right. So, and again, imagine we're all sitting around holding hands in a big circle. All right. So, excuse me. So see you in a few minutes. All right. Now we just bring our hands together. And we let the energy grow to a bright white light. And now we bring the energy into our hearts. Let it sit there for a moment. And now we send the energy out where it needs to go. And we stretch. We yawn. And we bring ourselves back. And I will say thank you very much for joining in today. And thank you, Joanne, for my belated happy birthday. Really appreciate it. Thanks for joining in. So mind yourselves, and mind how you feed your mind. We know there's still a lot of stuff going on, and that's a thing we have to work with. And I believe everyone is doing a fantastic job with themselves, for themselves, and obviously for the greater good. And keep it up. Well done. Mind yourselves, and love yourself. Go past the reflective surface and blow yourself a kiss. Go on. I dare you. It's your job to love yourself. And yeah. And it's a bonus being loved by other people. It really is. And it's a fantastic thing. I know that because I'm a recipient of such love. And I really do appreciate it. So I say to you, love yourself and embrace the love you're given. And send out the love to others as well. So mind yourself. Have a lovely day. Chat to you again. And I think tomorrow, if I'm correct in my calculations, is broadcast number 60. So there's a few of us who have already celebrated their 60th live broadcasts, and I'm chuffed for them, obviously. And I am now going to be one of them. So I'm chuffed for myself. So well done me, and well done you for joining in. And I'll see you out there. So I'll see you tomorrow at number 60. And have a nice day, and go about yourself with pride and love and joy. All right. Love and rock and roll. Love you. See ya. Thank you. I love me too. Have a nice day.